Good morning. Welcome to Christian Life Church's Extreme Teen Sunday. I'm Ella Simpson, and you are in for a real treat this morning. And I know that because the Holy Spirit is moving. That's why I fumbled over a few words during worship. And that's why we were praying and crying over Sarah. And that's why we know that she's going to be okay. But before we begin, I would like to thank Pastor Jared, the deacons, and the family of God at Christian Life Church for the opportunity to host Teen Sunday. We, along with our youth director, Dave, are thankful for your support of prayer, encouragement, and finances so the teens of Christian Life Church can be extreme in Jesus. Thank you. As we move along this morning, we'll share a message and skit called Break Every Chain. You'll also hear from every teen about a powerful song and how there is power in the name of Jesus. Names. Everyone has one. My name is Ella Marie Simpson. There's nothing special about it, and it doesn't connect with a notable name in history. Maybe it's special to a few people here, like my parents and my grandparents. But it's not a name that, when mentioned, you would recognize. However, there are names I can say that will make you think of historical events or certain times in history. Names like Christopher Columbus, Abraham Lincoln, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., Paul Newman, John Wayne, Terry Bradshaw, Franco Harris, Steve Martin, or Pee Wee Herman. Names can also have a meaning behind it. My name, Ella, in the Bible, it means goodness and light. The name Kyla means victorious in Hebrew. And there are funny names too, like Crispy Bacon or Kenny Wood, and of course, Jim Bag. But there is one name, only one name, that has divided history, that marks time, that is above all other names. There is power in the name of Jesus Christ. It is clearly stated in Philippians 2:9, therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name. And if you do not know it now, after today, you will know there is power in the name of Jesus. Let's get ready for today. Standing with me are the Extreme Teens, and a few of them are working behind the scenes too. We want to share with you today that there is power in the name of Jesus.
It all started way back in the Old Testament in the book of Isaiah 9:6. The prophet says, "For to us a child is born, to us a son is given. And the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." The fact that his name will be Mighty God, right there you know that his name will break every chain. Now that is exciting.
The song you will hear during the skit, Break Every Chain, centers around the concept of surrendering ourselves to God and allowing him to break the chains that hold us captive. The lyrics acknowledge that we all experience struggles, trials, and addictions that can overpower us. However, through surrendering to God's grace and power, we can find freedom from these chains. The song encourages listeners and you today to release your burdens, fears, and sins to Jesus, who alone has the authority to break every chain and set you free.
Bless you. This powerful anthem serves as a reminder that no matter how broken or shackled we may feel, there is hope and liberation available through every individual through Jesus Christ. It emphasizes the importance of faith in overcoming our personal challenges and finding the true freedom in him. This song's infectious energy and heartfelt lyrics resonate with listeners who long for the release from the bondage that weighs them down.
Our prayer with this song and with every song we sing is that God's power and presence will be demonstrated in your lives the same as it's been demonstrated in our lives. Rise up with us in this freedom and in Christ, and let's be a mighty army in his name, doing greater works for his glory.
The song lyrics are simple. I'd like to share a sample. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Remember in Acts 12, 6 through 7, the disciple Peter was in jail, sleeping between two soldiers and bound to two chains. An angel of the Lord appeared to him on his side and told him to get up quick, and those chains fell off. Those chains were broken. There is power in the name of Jesus.
Tasha Cobbs Leonard drew inspiration to write Break Every Chain from her personal experience while seeking deliverance and surrendering to God's transforming power. She shares how she witnessed firsthand the way God can break chains in the lives of those who earnestly seek Him. This inspired her to write a song that would be a powerful declaration of liberation and a reminder of God's ability to break every chain. The phrase "break every chain" is a reference to various aspects of bondage, such as sin, addiction, fear, and spiritual oppression. It signifies the power and authority of God to release individuals from their entanglements and provide freedom. This song serves as a declaration and an invocation to call upon the Lord's divine intervention to break chains that hinder spiritual oppression, spiritual growth, and personal well-being. Sorry.
Well, Break Every Chain does have its roots in Christian faith. It also has powerful themes of freedom, of deliverance, and of the desire for a higher power to break the chains that bind us. This song has touched the hearts of individuals from all different walks of life, offering peace and encouragement in each of their personal journeys. Break Every Chain is widely recognized as a worship song due to its captivating melody and spiritual lyrics. It's sung during gatherings where believers seek to connect with God on a deeper level. The song's emphasis on releasing burdens and finding freedom in Christ aligns with the core principles of worship, making it a significant addition to any service.
Break Every Chain has had a profound impact on listeners worldwide. It has provided solace and comfort to those struggling with personal challenges, addictions, and spiritual bondage. The song's powerful lyrics and Tasha Cobbs Leonard's heartfelt delivery have the ability to resonate deeply with anyone in search of hope, healing, and freedom. Countless testimonies have emerged from individuals who have found encouragement, breakthrough, and a renewed sense of faith through this song.
This song is more than a pretty melody. It gives a clear description of what Christ came to do, as he said in Luke 4:18. The Spirit of the Lord is on me because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom from the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free. It reinforces the promise from God that each of us would experience and live out this freedom that Christ came to give us and to see us give that to others. I think that this song works best if we maintain that the name of Jesus is not some kind of incantation, but rather a confession. A confession that Jesus is the only name by which we are saved and the only name that we call Lord. His name stands forever as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, in an eternal kingdom where all forms of slavery have been defeated. Through that confession and praise of his name, Paul and Silas had their chains literally fall off. In the name of Jesus, we are no longer slaves to sin, but sons and daughters and fellow heirs with Christ.
What is the meaning behind the song Break Every Chain? This power we sing about is what loses us from the chains that have kept us bound and broken. You can't find this power to set you free in religion, tradition, forms, or steps. It's only in the name and the person of Jesus. Psalms 2:3 tells us, "Let us break the chains and throw off their shackles." I can't break those chains, but I only know one who will, and that is Jesus, because there's power in the name of Jesus.
In the skit we are about to perform, you will see how easily one can get entangled in sin. Hebrews 12:1 tells us, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles us." So what I say to you today is this: don't let those chains hold you down in the first place.
We sing, "There is power in the name of Jesus," but how do we know about that power? How do we know that his name is above every name? Philippians 2:9 tells us so. Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name. Wow. Yes, wow. The name of Jesus is above every name ever spoken in the history of the world. And we know that one day every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
One time, Jesus sent out 72 people ahead of him to every town and told them the harvest is plentiful, but the workers were few. When the 72 people returned, it says in Luke 10:17, the 72 returned with joy and said, "Lord, even the demons submit to us in your name."
Power in the name of Jesus. There sure is. In Matthew 1:21, it says, "She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." The power to forgive sins.
Power in the name of Jesus. Wow, check this one out. Mark 16:17 and 18. "And these signs will accompany those who believe. In my name, whose name? Jesus. They will drive out demons, they will speak in new tongues, they will pick up snakes with their hands, and when they drink deadly poison, it will not hurt them at all. They will place their hands on sick people, and they will get well."
Power in the name of Jesus we also know from Acts 4:12. "Salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given to mankind by which we must be saved." Now think about that. There is no other name which mankind can be saved.
In this skit we are about to perform, you will see how Jesus died for us, yet he also broke the chains of death. Jesus defeated death, and he came to us to break the chains that Satan has wrapped around us. Even the demons know about the power in Jesus' name, because in Mark 1:2 it says, "What do you want with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." Those stinking demons knew the name of Jesus has the power to break every chain.
Not many times do we hear a quote from the book of Nahum, but today you will. In Nahum 1:13, "Now I will break their yoke from your neck and tear your shackles away." Yes, God through his son Jesus will break and tear away the shackles that bind you.
It's getting exciting now, and the skit will begin soon, but I want to share with you from Isaiah 5:2. "Shake off your dust, rise up, sit enthroned Jerusalem. Free yourself from the chains on your neck, daughter Zion, now a captive. Get rid of those chains that bind you, and you can be victorious in Jesus. Yes, he will break every chain." Paul's prayer from Ephesians 1:19 talks about this power. "I also pray that you will understand the incredible greatness of God's power for us who believe in him. This is the same mighty power that raised Christ from the dead and seated him in the place of honor at God's right hand in the heavenly realms." In Romans 8:11, he explains that same power lives in us. "And if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you."
God who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies because of his spirit who lives in you. If that same power resides in us and can raise the dead, don't you know that it can raise you out of addiction, depression, pain, doubt, lies, and any chain that's bound you? Now sit back and relax as we get ready to perform Break Every Chain.
right. So we've done a lot of Youth Sundays before, and as you all know, it's a tradition that we give you a trinket after everyone as a reminder of the message that we spoke about. This time we're passing out bracelets with a message on it, and it says, break every chain, and also Isaiah 9:6 on it, to help you remember that the name of Jesus Christ can break every chain. And of course, because our youth director is Dave, they had to be camo too. We hope that every time you wear them, you'll think about our skit and our message, and you won't succumb to the chains that Satan tries to bind you in. I also have another thing that I like to talk about that was not rehearsed. Dave put me up to it. I'm a little bit sad today, church, because this will be my last Youth Sunday ever. If you don't know me, I'm a senior in high school, and I'm one amongst four in this group. Robbie is here. Evan, where's Evan at? Evan is there, and Cecilia up in the rafters. Can we give them a round of applause? Like I said, I didn't talk with them, and this was a total surprise for them, but I think that I can speak for all of us when I say that we are so grateful for our youth pastor, Dave, all of our other youth group members, and our church family who has supported us as we've grown up. We've been welcomed, we've been prayed for, we've been encouraged through difficult times. I have grown up in this church for most of my life, but not all of it, and I can confidently say that I would never be the person that I am today without you guys. So as we get ready to depart from youth group and head on our own separate paths, we would like to thank you, CLC family, for everything that you've done for us.
This is the youth group of Christian Life Church. Our name says it all because it invokes the name that breaks every chain, the name of Jesus, the one who defeated death. He is the one whose blood will cover your sins by asking him into your life and by asking him to forgive you. Jesus Christ is Lord. Yes, we are the extreme teens for Jesus, and today we ask you to join us in prayer at the altar here so he will break every chain.
Spirit of the Lord is here.
Take a moment and just sing this song with us. This was the song that was the theme of the day today.
And there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power. Break every chain.
There is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. He breaks every chain. Breaks every chain. Breaks every chain.
He's the all-sufficient.
He's the all-sufficient sacrifice. So freely given, such a price. But our redemption,
blood, for your blood, the blood of your Son that you gave as a gift freely to us, Lord, to wash away our sin, to break the chains. We thank you, Lord, for the cross. Lord, we ask that you would go with each one as they leave this place, and we bless your name again today. We give you grace and thanks and peace, and Lord, we thank you for all that you are. In your name I pray. Amen. Thank you for coming today. I hope you enjoyed the Teen Sunday service, and have a great week, everyone.